Copy from here. New layer. Paste. Position 6161. 6161. And then again, we delete the boot. And then and now, okay, so now we can start drawing ankles. Because everyone loves ankles. Ankles are really great. Without ankles, think of how hard it would be to like do things like stand upright and not fall over all the time. Actually, no, I guess that part would be easy. But then, like when you go to move and stuff, like, you know, how do you walk on those crazy like feet that don't rotate and stuff, or the feet that are always just like rigidly at an angle? Like, I don't think anyone is necessarily anti-ankles. I don't think I'm necessarily like trying to convince anyone that ankles are a good thing, but I just wanted to voice that support for a very important hinge. I mean, there's some hinges on the body that's like, pff, you know, you could do without them, right? Like if your elbows didn't bend, like you could get through life just going like this a lot. But like if your ankles didn't bend, that'd be really difficult. I don't know what I'm saying. I really don't have things to say when I'm working on art a lot of the time. I just run out. Like when working on like code stuff, like there's constantly like some puzzle to like decipher and like nope. Not so with art. With art, it's like, I mean, it's like my brain is still working on it, right? But it's like, it's just like doing different things. It's like, it's not like, it's just not synthesizing language. So I end up saying dumb things. I apologize. But that said, if anyone has like a question or something, I'm also fully capable of answering questions when working on art stuff, because that is entirely easy or entirely doable. And the hotkeys, like if I click off the canvas, like the hotkeys stop working, and like in order to get them to start working again, I have to click on the canvas. But if I have the wrong tool selected, in order to click on the canvas, I have to like apply the wrong mark onto the canvas, and it's annoying, but whatever. Why is this, what freaking layer am I on right now? What the frick? Freaking layers, always wrong, never. All right. Sorry. Like, I'm not good with layers, and then I think the fact that this file right now has like so many layers is not helping. So all right, we can do this though. We'll get through this. Yeah, it doesn't have to be anything sophisticated. It just has to be like that. It just has to be like pants that connect at the ankle. All right, so let's go down to the correct layer here. And hey, look, we actually don't even have to scroll our layers list anymore, because like all the feet layers can now fit on the same screen now that there are not like gratuitously many extra feet layers. Yeah, so that's pretty much all we need to do there. Let's save that, just because we've done a lot since the last time I saved. So alright, so let's hide 2 and 0. Let's show 0A and 2A. Let's do these one at a time. It might be helpful to draw these on separate layers a little bit in some ways, but it's definitely not necessary, so I won't stress about it. Let's go with a slightly smaller brush just to do some of this like fine cleanup, just like that a little bit. Actually, I'll use like the dark, like slightly shaded tone there. No, that doesn't look right. I'll just have it come down further. But I'll use the correct tone to do it. That's fine. no pants. I was thinking at some point we'd probably do like, I mean, we do like different things, right? So like at some point there'll probably be a character with like a loincloth, if that counts as undies. Because like at some point you're probably going to go become like a barbarian type character. Like I kind of want to, like basically what I'm doing is I'm just like going through different like Yeah, I want a lot of diversity in the game. Like, so for basically anything you could think of, it'll probably be in the game at some point. It's mostly like when I work on art, it's mostly just a matter of like, what do we want to do next? Like, because it's all like so far, it's all like mostly linear. So it's basically at any given point, it's just like, so okay, so we were just like a mystic. What should we be next? Like, what's the next step in this progression? And I try and come up with like weird answers too. Like I don't I try I kind of basically avoid things that are like too simple or obvious or like expected or like too sensible even. Like I try and well, all right, I mean it's not always like completely like crazy like off the wall stuff, 'cause like so far it goes like the original adventure I just call like the adventure, and then like the second adventure I call the bard, not for any good reason. Like I probably shouldn't do that. I should probably just call it like adventure like 1 and 2 or something. Also, I'm not doing anything good to this foot. I should stop touching it. I should probably just call it like adventure 1 and 2 because like yeah, it's basically like you start out as like an adventure. You start out as like. As like a person with like a hiking a walking stick and like a backpack and stuff, and like you're ready to go, ready to start. Yeah, how does the character develop in game? Yeah, okay, so oh here, I can give you a brief visual example of how the characters develop in game. So like if we go to side quest level So like this is your character at level 12. This is the adventure that I was talking about. This is like the advanced adventure. I can help with that. Paddle. Okay. oh, Yakima's got it too. Okay. so this is the character at level 12, and then at level 21, your character becomes like an archer. and then at level 30, your character becomes like a mystic. And then at level 38, your character becomes like I called this character like the brigand, I guess. I don't know. And then at level 44, your character becomes this character. I have no clue what this character is. I call it like the I've been calling it like the cook because I just have no clue what to call it. Someone said it looks like a medic, which I think kind of makes sense. So like, I don't know, maybe the medic would make more sense. But I probably will make like an intentional medic at some point. So I don't know. and then was it? Oh yeah, that was level 44. And then at level 51, your character becomes I've called this character the farmer or the pirate interchangeably, like the farmer pirate or the pirate farmer. Not the pirate farmer, because that makes it sound like someone who cultivates pirates, but no. And then, oh yeah, and so then the highest level that we have so far is the standard bearer, which yeah, is this character here. So yeah, so far it's like the character progression. It's like I'm intentionally like making it like winding and weird and like I don't know. Who goes from being like a pirate to being like a standard bearer? I don't know. Everyone does, I guess. yeah. All right, so right, okay, so these legs look good, so we're making progress with this stuff. Whoops, wait, what? Why is it asking me to Oh, I must have had the wrong window selected when I hit Control S. Because I wanted this window selected. Yeah, okay, there we go. I don't know what I was accidentally trying to save, but whatever. Let's go onwards to foot Foot's layer 1, for example. Okay, so yeah, this one's pretty straightforward. Whoops, wrong tool. Wrong size tool. Yeah, so this is just a matter of connecting these back together again. And look at that. Look at that. Oh, I'm on the wrong layer. I'm always on the wrong layer. I'm always on the wrong layer. Sorry. Sorry. You know what I kind of need is like a tool to like switch to layers like based on like the image, like what's in the image, but not based on like this list over here. Or like, I don't know, maybe I just need this. I don't know what's wrong with me. I just cannot for the life of me stay on the correct layer. It's just not within my capabilities. Like, I can do a lot of things, but staying on the correct layer, no. Nope. Not in my skill set. All right, so so that was foot one, so let's show foot three. And again, very straightforward, just reconnecting with dearly distant and beloved ankles and feet. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm just saying ankles and feet for some reason. This is fine, like that. Okay. All right. So one more set of feet left. So 1A and 1A and oh yeah. So this is an example where like this foot doesn't need to be as shaded as it is here. I guess it's not such a bad thing if it is, but like, I don't know. I think like before it didn't used to be as shaded, so I might not want to make it as shaded anymore. I might actually want to I might want to because like it was that shaded because the kilt was here, and so like, you know, like it like really would cast like a big shadow here. But like, I don't know. Now that it's not, now that the kilt is gone, we can lighten up, I guess. Sure, that's fine. Why not? Okay, and then right, and so we'll continue the. Okay, this is the one that like I cut a little bit of the knee off. But actually, wait, hold on, let's do that again. Because let's actually not bring it up so tight like that. Let's instead do to do. Yeah, a little more like that. So there's like a slight separation there, kind of. Oops, that came too far down. Because the pants are actually only supposed to come down like to there, I guess. Yeah, I like that. All right, that's a little too far. So there will be a little more of like a connection there. It's not crazy much. Yeah. They'll just be like kind of adjacent, kind of. Actually, all right, but then like this knee, I guess, would come down a little further. So I guess they do kind of connect. Oh well, whatever. It's fine. Kind of sucks that you can't have a class you could pick that you could, for example, help succeed in current. Well, you know, it's funny that you mentioned that. Is that w one of the things that I had in my backlog, like the way I have my backlog organized, I have like the things that I know I want to do, and then I have this limbo list where like these are all the things that like I kind of wanted to do at one point, but then like for whatever reason, like I changed my mind, or like I haven't figured out exactly what I want to do with it yet, or I know I might want to do it like sometime in the future, but it's not like I'm not ready to do it yet. And it's funny you should mention that, because the thing that I added just back into the I like just before I started the stream today, from Limbo, I pulled from Limbo back into the future list, the character attributes, and what so I guess I might as well. Because I can play, I really need to be taking so many breaks from this art stuff. It's gonna like fry my brain if I try and do it all in one constant stretch. But so I'll just take a quick break to talk about a little bit of what I'm thinking for like the future of strength, wisdom, and agility. Is basically like character classes. Like it occurred to me like one of the reasons that we never had character customization, or one of the reasons that this game didn't, yeah, the reason that this game hasn't had character customization from the start is because I didn't want to like clutter up the chat interface with people like, you know, like spamming these like, you know, all these little commands to like tweak their and tune their character. But yeah, so strength, wisdom, and agility was something that I came up with a while back that I was thinking of implementing, and the reason I brought it back is because I kind of want to I kind of want to I was thinking of like, okay, so we added in gambits just last week. Gambits allow you to augment the action commands that you're already inputting. So for example, like right now, like so in the most recent event, like you had the options to paddle or to braid. To paddle an ice floe out into icy waters, or to braid rope to help pull the. It's a rescue mission, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. What you can do now with the gambits is that you can, instead of just choosing your action, you can also like shift the course of events. I won't go into detail about about how that all works. We've covered that in detail previously. So the thing that was occurring to me with like strength, wisdom, and agility is that we could treat that in a similar way. Oh yeah, okay. So strength, wisdom, and agility. Originally, I was thinking I would annotate all of the actions in an event to have a given attribute, and so you could choose an action to in order to develop a given attribute. So, for example, for that example, maybe paddling would have been connected with strength, and braiding would have been connected with agility. So, like, or wisdom or something. So that, like, if you choose those actions, you develop those statistics. The reason I didn't want to go with that ultimately is because it would have been an awful lot of annotation. And I wouldn't have minded doing it for the prescripted events, but for the events that like run for the events that are like that I run like through the secret panel, or like for the events that like are not prescripted, for the events that are just like happening live, I guess, it's an extra level of not fun. It's if anything inhibitive, which I wouldn't want it to be. I'd want it to be quite the opposite. I'm trying to make it like I'm trying to make that that aspect of the game like very accessible, as accessible as I can. Where was I going with that? Oh yeah. So it occurred to me with gambits that we could do it like that. So instead of like predefining like which actions like instead of predefining like which actions correspond to which attributes, like players could essentially like choose like which attributes they develop. And like I still don't know exactly how this is gonna work exactly, but like I don't know. I was just thinking like yeah, so basically players could choose like how to develop their characters, and then and so then like they wouldn't have to make like explicit decisions like at any given time. Like there wouldn't be like a command to change your character class, but like you could like steer your own character development in that way. So yeah, like there's still some things I haven't figured out about how that's gonna work, but it is something that I want to I've like been thinking about and kind of want to bring back. So yeah, we could see that in the probably not too distant future. It might be the slightly distant future, because I do have like pretty much all this stuff I have stacked up on top of it is like the backlog is in a pretty good order right now. So like I do want to do a lot of these things first. I mean, probably not literally all of these things, but like a lot of these things. So we'll see. Oh yeah, and everything here too. Like I need to the fox, the owl, the turtle. Fox is gonna be the difficult one. The other two are gonna be really easy. But yeah. We'll see. I'm still in the middle of the animation evaluation, so I mean we're further through the evaluation at this point. Like we're almost done with the evaluation. Finishing up the legs is basically like when I'm gonna consider the evaluation like done. And then actually, yeah, when I finish up the legs, I don't know, I'll want to do the fox and the owl and the turtle before I was gonna say, once I finish up the legs, I can switch the system over. But no, I'll want to do the fox, the owl, and the turtle before I switch the system over. The fox in particular. Maybe, yeah. Yeah, the fox is the difficult one, and it's also the one that needs it the most. Because right now the fox would look hilariously bad if I tried to just, like, if I just amped up the with like some of the other you're right. So the so if you notice Yakimus over there, it's kind of subtle. It's hard to see in the snow. Oh, Lauren. Well, yeah. Again, it's hard to see in the snow, but Lauren has an owl flying next to him. I don't know if you can see. Yakimus over there has like a little blackbird following him around, And oh, this adventurer, I don't know who it is, but they have a turtle on top of their head. Again, it's hard to see in the snow. But yeah. There you get animal companions too, so so right, so the for like the so there's the mouse, there's the blackbird, there's the turtle, there's the fox, there's the owl, and then there's the little dog. And so the mouse, the blackbird, and the little dog are all so small that for their animate for their other frames of animation, we're actually just gonna make their animation go faster. We're just gonna make it loop faster because the little blackbird is gonna have to flap its wings faster than the owl, for example, just to keep up. And then same with the mouse and the little dog. They're gonna be moving very fast, like little, like little, just to, in order to keep up, they're gonna be very hurried. But then the fox, the owl, and the turtle, those ones are a little bit bigger, so I'll want to actually like add in new frames of animation. And for like the owl, it's gonna be very simple. It's just gonna be like twi it's gonna it's just like the owl doesn't really flap its wings. The owl just kind of like glides a little bit, so it'll just be like more like feather movement. For the turtle, it's really hard to see in the snow. You probably can't make out this detail, but the turtle actually like it's resting on top of the adventurer's head, but it moves its legs as if it's walking, because I thought that would be hilarious, and I still think it's hilarious. So I'm just gonna make it so that it moves its legs a little slower, or like it doesn't move its legs faster. It still moves its legs at the same pace, I guess. Whoops, sorry, I just ripped out my headphones. It's a good thing my headphones rip out so easily, because otherwise I'd be throwing my tablet on the floor a lot, a lot. Oops. Wait, why did the thing go away? And the little button to play music, it went away. Sorry, just one second. do do do. Sorry, I just queue up the music again. I had to look at my mobile device, and then I got distracted by notifications. But okay. Yeah, you get the animals like as you adventure. It's part of like the character arc. So like oh, like the things that we were sh the list that we were looking at earlier, like with so like yeah, so this is the this list that we were looking at is like the level ups you get. So like at level 12 you're this adventurer, and then at level 13 like a little pet mouse. It's kind of hard to see, but like, yeah, there's like a little pet mouse that follows you around, and then, so at level 21 you become the archer, and then at level 22 you get a little blackbird that follows you around, and yeah, so yeah, it's just kind of it happens like at points in your adventure. Yeah, so let's do what? Let's whoops. Let's get back to work. did I finish the ankles and stuff, or do I probably still have like one more ankle to do? Do do do. So right, so there's so that one came out okay, and then I think there's the last ankle. Yeah, here we go. And once we finish this one, we will be good with this set of whatever. With a set of legs or equipments or whatever, stuff, et cetera, et cetera. I don't know why my words are failing right now. But whatever. Okay. There we go. Yeah. All right. So let's save this, and then, so now let's export this. Oh, I drew that on the wrong layer. Of course, I drew that on the wrong layer. Why on earth would I draw that on the correct layer? What craziness would cause me to draw anything on the correct layer ever in my life? Okay. So cut this, put a new layer down here, paste this, and smoosh these together. There we go. All right, there we go. All right, so let's take extents on this. So foot, 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 foot. There we go. Oops, one more. There we go. Okay. Do to do. Ah, smudgy pixels. Smudgy pixels. How dare you, smudgy pixels? Get out. Out, smudgy pixels, out. Where'd you come from? Where are you coming from, Smudgy Pixels? There we go. Okay. Sorry, that was super important. Okay. And so, okay, the extents. I might want to take a break from all this, like, fancy. Sorry. I was gonna say I want to take a break from like what I'm working on right now, and somehow it was excuse me, somehow it almost came out as taking a break from all this fancy. Excuse me, all this. Sorry. All this fancy footwork. all right, wait, hold on. I should do the. I should, as per usual, I should do the. I should do the data first before I forget. Yeah, right. So, legs. New folder for black pants. Art test. I wonder how many. No, I don't even want to think about it. I was gonna say, I wonder how many of these, what percentage of these I've done yet, but I'm probably still only about like halfway done with these. Cause like later on, I started getting really liberal with like how many leg layers I'd used. It gets a little out of control at some point. This will be an ongoing task though. This might go down in side quest history as the least interesting thing I've done on this project. But no. Like I said, I'm gonna be a really good artist by the time I'm done with this. Or no, I'll just have like a new, I don't know. I'll have more experience with animation, which is neat. Okay. I'm gonna try and get less distracted. I'm gonna try and like be more fastidious and diligent about this. 'Cause like the longer I make this, like the longer, the more I drag this out, just the longer it's gonna take overall. So, all right, so 61, 48, 21. Save this, and then yeah. So, right. So, foot layer 0. Copy file new. Okay, paste. Save as. Legs, black pants, oops, legs, black pants art test, 0.png. Okay, and foot layer 0A, copy, file, new, okay, paste, save as 0A. Okay, do to do foot 0. Oh, when I switch between. I switched between things, it like I was like wondering why the layers list kept getting like scrolled to weird places, but like when I switched, that's so annoying. So annoying. All right, whatever. All right, so this is layer 1. Save as layer 1. Wait, is there like, did I accidentally draw something on the wrong layer here? Yeah, what the heck is, oh, yeah, of course I drew that on the wrong layer. Of course I drew that on the wrong layer. That is clearly supposed to be on layer, not this one. layer 3 instead. So let's go down to layer 3. Add this in, paste this, and squish these layers together. I'm just gonna assume that that is correct. Let's take extents again. Oh, well, that went well. And then let's just do number 3 real quick. New. Okay, paste. Yeah, that was correct. My assumption was correct. So there we go. All right, so 3 is good to go. And then for this one, it's basically just getting rid of that lump. Oops. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, save that. Good. So then, all right, well, 3 is done. But I still haven't done 1A. File new. Okay. Paste, save as 1A. Okay, and then let's do Foot two, copy, file new. Okay, paste, save. Number two, go. Oops, did I hit cancel or save? Yeah, I hit cancel. Oops. Okay. And then 2A. 2A Brute. Or would it wait, no, it'd be 2A at no, 2 whatever. I was gonna make a stupid joke, but it didn't work. file new. Yeah, I have to stop getting distracted. I really have to stop getting distracted. So 2A. All right. And then 3 is done already, so 3A is the last one. File new. Okay. Paste, save. What kind of games do I like to play? I like to play I like to play a lot of games. Like, if I had like a ton of free time, I'd play way more games than I do currently. I tend to like games that I tend to like games that I can get good at. Like, I'll usually at like most times I'll have like one game that like I'm actively like trying to get better at, or like that like one game that has like a lot of room, like that has a high like skill ceiling. And then like apart from that, I usually like I'll play like a lot of lighter stuff. Like I'll play stuff that yeah, I'll kind of like only play one of those at a time because like I don't know, like if I'm like if there are two games that I want to get good at the same time, like that doesn't like work for me, like right? Because like when I'm I because I like I know I'm not going to become great at like two games, and I know I'm not going to get great at like even one game, but like at least if I only have like one game like that on my slate, then I'll I can at least pretend that maybe who knows, maybe someday I'll get great at it. So like right now the game that like the skill based game that and I know it's gonna sound funny. For anyone who plays it, it's gonna sound funny to be calling it a skill-based game, but Hearthstone. I know like it is there's skill involved there, right? It's not like I mean there's a lot of RNG involved as well. And so there's some variance too, but like there's also a lot of skill involved. So that's like the game that I've been focusing on lately as like I was like filling that niche or filling that that space. And then apart from that, I tend to play like yeah, I'll play like basically anything that crosses my path, like anything that sounds interesting or that I've heard good things about, or you know just that maybe is different or that I want to try or is free. That one also I get a lot of games I'll play for that reason. All right, what is next on the list? The next thing on the list is boots. All right, so this is gonna be fun. This is all gonna be fun. This is game development. Fun is the watchword. But this, I guess, especially will be fun. All right, so zero. All right, here we are. Boots. So the boots, these boots, bootsy boots. Sorry, what am I saying? The boots that I'll be drawing next are. Wait, is it even chain boots? Oh, wait a second. No, the leg armor. Wait. Black pants. Wait, what actually comes next on this list? Because I don't want to miss one. It's easier to do them in the correct order. Oh, and I guess I should test to make sure that those ones look okay. As I tend to. So, alright, so sandals art test. Let's replace sandals art test with black pants art test. Black pants. Art test, replace all, save. Is that, did I get the name correct? Yeah, black pants art test. Okay, so let's check out what those ones look like. Run this. Oh yeah, I forgot. I forgot the speed is still uncapped. I should really cap the speed. What say? So let's go to anim cooldown. And yeah, okay. So save that, and then let's try that again. All right. So yeah, that seems okay. Okay. So then Hey Jacko, how's it going? Oh, today's a special day. What's so special about today, might I ask? I mean, I have reasons why I think today is special, but why is today special to you? And what was I working on? Oh yeah, okay, so I tested and that looked good. Oh yeah, I was gonna check the other thing. Yeah, to just to make sure. Okay, so we just did black pants, which are here. Yeah, black and skirt actually comes before chain boots. So black and skirt is like basically just what we have already, except with a skirt over it. So yeah, black and skirt. So it's like just look at these layers here. Because you get this like what is supposed to be like a chain skirt, and you get this before you get yeah, this is like the next upgrade. So let's add this in now. I mean, it's gonna be pretty straightforward. It's like I'm gonna copy and paste it for starters, and then like I'm gonna touch it up because like the it's not gonna fit exactly. But oops, I should make a new layer for this. So deselect new layer above foot 0, paste this. Yeah, so I mean it's mostly gonna go like this, right? It's mostly just gonna like kind of slap on right here. Wait, is it? Yeah, I guess that must be how it goes. Is that how it's supposed to go? I guess. I don't know. Something like this, like somewhere right in this spot here. Okay, and then so now let's just clean this up to the shape that we have going on here, which is different than it used to be. Because we changed a lot of the we just changed a lot when we made this new version of the walk cycle. For example, like the leg comes up now more like this. So oh, I should use a bigger brush. The leg comes up more like this. So yeah, so the chain. Well, actually, I guess it would come across the leg a little bit. It would come like across the leg and down like that. But yeah, more like that. All right, well, that was actually pretty easy. I think that's basically the conversion for this piece. All right, so yeah, let's today is the day when your family and friends come to one place to celebrate that day and talk about your past. Are you having an intervention today? Happy intervention, Jocko. Yeah, wow, I didn't even know you needed an intervention. That's outstanding. I'm glad to hear that. Sorry. Sorry, I'm a dork or something. I don't know what's wrong with me. But no, wait, let's think about this. Today is the day when your friends and family come to celebrate the day and talk about your past. I don't know. Is that a tradition of some sort? I don't know if I'm familiar with that tradition. Talk about your past. I can think of two occasions, and none of them are exciting. Like, 'cause the two occasions I can think of are an intervention or your funeral. Maybe I'm just like really grim-minded, but like, oh, it's your birthday! Yay, your birthday! Happy birthday! I guess that makes sense too. Yeah, no, that's good. All right, yeah, I get it. I get it now. I guess I just have a really grim mind, so it didn't. For some reason, that wasn't the first one that came to mind. But hey, happy birthday! Happy birthday, Jocko! Oh, I should make a thing where like I can actually like set a character's birthday in this game, so that way you're guaranteed to get the happy birthday event in side quest on your birthday. I could do that. I'm not gonna do it right now though. So, what am I gonna do right now? Yeah, I'm just gonna continue on with the chain skirt. All right, so yeah, so that's for foot layer 0. So let's I'm just gonna duplicate this layer actually and see how it looks for the next leg layer. So let's try it with 2 and 2A and see what needs to change. All right, yeah, so clearly stuff needs to change. For example, really? Oh, that's so weird. No, I guess that makes enough sense. Like, with the way the walk cycle works, like, your leg. Your knee comes up higher in the second frame of like the step animation. I don't know. It's kind of weird, but whatever. All right. So basically, what's gonna happen is, so this is gonna come up higher like this, and then I'm gonna put some shading down here because like, I don't know. It's just weird that like, there's like it'd just be weird if there was like literally no shading at all. So I'm just gonna slightly higher brush width, and then just like. At this point, it's not going to be like a ton of shading, but there's we're just going to introduce a little bit down here, because like your leg is like far enough forwards that I think it would like, I don't know, the way it would pull the chain mail, I don't know, whatever. It's just going to be like this. Deal with it. No, I'm just kidding. Actually, I could go a little more with that. I could do a little more, because the chain is like a very, like the even the quote unquote dark ch t blah, 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 the quote unquote dark tone of the chain is not very dark, so. Yeah. That could be fine. Okay. Cool. So that's not that hard. Oh, these smudgy pixels. Smudgy pixels everywhere. They're like not noticeable. They're not very noticeable at any rate, but like they're just ever so slightly noticeable, so like every now and again I'm like, "Oh gosh, they're there." And I must destroy them. So if like when I the reason I mentioned that they're not very noticeable is that some people are probably like, what is he looking at? Like he's hallucinating. There's nothing there. There are just little like pixels that really don't matter. Like they're not gonna affect anything if I just leave them there, but I'd rather them not be there. All right, and now they're gone. So okay. No. That's so Badler Pete, if this is what you saw earlier and thought that, you're wrong. It doesn't look like that. If you don't mind, there's nothing personal. I'm gonna rinse your chat, but it doesn't look like that, and that's just you. So, I am not gonna get super distracted, but no, I'm not even gonna go there. Not one bit. I'll just suffice to say that is all you. That is 100% you, and we are going to continue on. All right, so yeah, so that's good too, I guess now. And then, all right, so yeah, I guess for the other two frames of animation, it's probably gonna be more akin to this skirt version. So I'm gonna instead of duplicating that other layer, I'm gonna start copying this one over. Hold on, I'll be a little more precise about it. Do-do-do. Oops. All right. Well, I'm gonna try and be more precise about it. All right, whatever. This is good enough. I'll just oops, wrong tool. I'll just touch it up with that. And that and that and that, I guess. What was your question? Oh, what is your gift from me? Side quest. Have a happy side quest. No. Oh, okay. So let's say, oh, I forgot what the command is. Hold on. I don't use this command very often, so I forget what it even is. It's like bonus or something. It's, what is it? Give. Wait, is it give? No, give's not right. It's bonus. Yeah, it is bonus. All right, so, bonus, percent, so percent, so some adventures, find a, tremendous, or, okay, yeah, so a kindly spelled correctly, kindly, baker, I'm just, I guess I might as well show this on screen, because whatever. Okay, so kindly baker gifts the adventuring party with a delicious 5-layer. Oh, well, we just got a bonus, whatever. With the delicious. That was your. If you got a glimpse of the Sprightly Fairy Folk, then that was your birthday present. Delicious 5-layer cake. What type of frosting do you like, Jocko? This is an important question. what type of cake do you like, and what type of frosting do you like? And in the meantime, while you're answering that question, I'll go back here. And yeah, so let's copy this and do do do. So let's so foot so let's hide layer foot layer 0A and all this business and. And let's show foot layer 3 and 1, and let's make a new layer above here and paste this in. And yeah, so this will basically be. All right. Well, let's change a lot. But this will be like the gist kind of what we're doing here. Okay. So yeah. So this. This do 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 yeah, this came down a little bit, and then so yeah, it'll come up like this as such, and then yeah, and then oh yeah, so then this section, yeah, I guess it comes up a little higher here, or maybe the pants are too high. Maybe this is actually the right height, and these pants just come up too high, or something. I don't know. Hard to say. Oops, wrong layer. Do-do-do. Oh yeah, part of it is that. Oh yeah, I actually accidentally picked up some of the, whatever. All right. So this is fine. Do-do-do. I can't give you your birthday present, Jocko, until you tell me what type of cake you like. What type of cake? What type of frosting? We're waiting on you. It's your big day. I'm just sorry. I won't give you flack on your on. It's your birthday, so take all the time you want, or don't even answer. sorry, I won't be a nag on your birthday. That's my gift to you. I won't be a nag on your birthday. all right. So do do do. I guess this is fine. Actually, yeah, no, I guess the angle of this leg would be a little bit different, though. And so as a result, the angle of this would be a little bit different. Whatever, this is fine. Okay. So, do do do. Oh, cool, you got a new phone? Nice. All right. Do do do. Doop-a-doop. What, all right, sorry, I'm just gonna touch this up real quick, with, I flattened that out a little too much, and then, yeah, that's fine. Okay, so now let's duplicate this layer, and bring it down here. Let's look at these layers. So what is it? Oh, no, wait, what the heck layer is that? I have no clue what's happening right now. Show this. Hide. Okay, there we go. This, hide this. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty close. So we just have to bring banana cake with strawberry and cheesecake. Wait, banana cake with strawberries and cheesecake style. Okay, I don't know what that means, but I'm gonna take it. I'm just gonna take it verbatim. Just gonna copy and or wait, no, copy and paste doesn't want to work, so I'll just say okay. So, delicious 5-layer banana cake with strawberries and cheese cake style. Some adventures. Oh, wait a second. Oh, is this gonna work? I wonder. Some. If so, yeah. Okay, sorry. The thing I'm looking at right now is that I made this 2 sentences long, and I think the way the some adventures thing works is like it'll only capitalize it correctly if it's at the start of the line, because I don't think I'm like checking for punctuation or anything like that. So I'll just say, okay, yeah, no, I know how to handle this. It's more than percent. So it's more than some adventurers can eat, I guess. How about that? All right, blammo. two adventures. It's more than two adventures can eat. Well, there you go. hey, Sogom, how's it going? Welcome. Let's get back to here because there's just a little touch up to do with this layer. And this one went quick, so I can't complain about this one. I mean, I shouldn't complain about any of them, but I especially cannot complain about this one, because this one is actually really easy overall. Of course, it's probably gone terribly wrong, and I probably have to like redo all of it for stupid reasons that don't make sense. But no, hopefully not. Okay, let's shrink that down a little bit, and I guess actually I could bring it up here. Yeah, whatever. Let's just call this. That's good. do to do, and then some fish, you say? All right. Bonus. Percent. Some adventurers caught fish for Jocko TM. Happy birthday. Oops. Spelled correctly. I'm gonna put it in quotes because this will be those adventurers saying it. Happy birthday. There. There you go. Hey. There you go. Okay. Don't mind me. Just banning someone on my other computer real quick and unbanning them. All right. hey, Stefan, how's it going? Welcome. So the game we're working on is actually what you see on the bottom of the screen there. It's called Side Quest, and it is a I describe it it's like I kind of like yeah it's kind of like if you were to play Dungeons and Dragons on Twitch. It's kind of like, I don't know, that's like the quick description of like what this game is, what it's supposed to be. Oh, where's this pixel? This is gonna annoy me if I can't figure out where this pixel is located, because I need to get rid of this pixel. Oh well, I'm not, my stupid mouse is not working because I was all right. Kind of a mess right now. I've been like making and like deleting layers like so much today, like so many layers, just like layers and layers and layers, like all over the place. Oh wow, that was on layer 3A. Yeah, whatever, I don't care. I might want to go and tidy up some other places as well, but right now I don't really care. So yes, no, right now I'm going to. Oh yeah, okay. So this. Oh, ah. Sha. All right, wait, hold on. Let me check something real quick. Let me get extents on this stuff that we just put in. Let's see what. Oh man, I think the. So I think the thing about the stuff that we just put in is that it's probably going to change the extents of the. Like the this by putting that little skirt on, like the chainmail skirt, by tacking that on, I think we change the extents. Otherwise, we'd be able to reuse a lot of these assets from the previous version of these of this like of this animation. But 60, 62, 61, 48, 8, 21. Hold on, we might actually be able to reuse a bunch of them, which would be just, I don't know, just kind of nice, right? So like. 62, 61, 48, 21. All right, we can. We totally can. All right, cool. So, right. So for starters, I can actually just copy this here and rename it to, what is this? This is black and skirt. Black and skirt art test. And cool. So right, so now I don't have to re-export like all these layers. I can just do all right, I'll just squish together the feet layers with the new art. So I can squish that together, I can squish that together, I can squish that together, I can squish this together. Right, and so now we only have to do the four top layers because the lower layers didn't change at all. So foot zero, copy this. Here, I can close these now because these are updated file. Open, right, so let's go to legs, black and skirt art test. Let's open 0 through 1A, and we can replace these as such. So blammo, save that. Okay. 0A, copy, paste, save. Okay. Anything that makes this export process a little easier is so welcome by me. I am all on board with making this export process easier, because it's typically just like the most tedious part. So, blam, blam-o, blam-o, slam-o-flam. Okay. What is wait, today's Tuesday. Not that that matters per se. I just mentioned that today's Tuesday because I guess I don't understand how fish works on Tuesday. I thought there was a day of the week where fish, where I understood how fish worked, but I don't think it was Tuesday. sorry. Okay. don't mind me. I'm not actually talking. I'm just kind of like rambling. Hey, I leveled up. I leveled up. Trusty Bard just let me know I leveled up. Yay me. okay, so the next step is boots, if I recall. Or actually, I guess I should check how the skirt looks. Why not? Okay. So let's replace this with I'm like begrudgingly like checking this stuff. I mean, I should be checking this stuff because if I'm not checking this stuff, like I might accidentally introduce an error. And if I like, if I'm, because like most of what I'm doing is like derivative on of the previous version, because like the way the upgrades, it like kind of stacks on top of itself. If I introduce an error, I'll want to have it fixed before I continue onwards because. The only thing worse than introducing an error is introducing an error and then letting it compound. So, how does this look? I think that looks fine. As far as I can tell, that looks fine. So, cool. Do-do-do. Huh. I still feel like the adventures should be moving faster. Like, they used to be 12, and then we tried 16, but 16 was too fast, and so this is like 14. Well, I guess no. I guess what I really want is I want the smoother scrolling, and then I can, yeah, because then I can set the speed, etc. Okay. yeah, so gone. Yeah, so gone. okay. Let's continue. Let us continue with the legs and the stuff and the whatnot. All right, so. We can hide some of these layers, and for what I'm working on now, I'm really tempted to just like get rid of some of these other layers. I'm just gonna get rid of some of these other layers because like these other layers are not useful right now, and anything I can get rid of right now that is gonna save on hassle, like I should just be doing that. So like for example, like chest layer 0 is just the pendant. Yeah, we can get rid of that for sure. And like head layer 0, like we haven't been showing that stuff in like forever, so we can get rid of that. And face, so we'll keep chest, we'll keep face just for context, but we can get rid of bonus, we can get rid of familiar. I mean, I'm probably, no, I'll keep hands in case I want to see the hands for some reason. But yeah, oh, I will have to bring back chest actually at some point. So I'll bring back chest, I guess. Chest. Oh shoot! What late? Oh yeah. I should have kept track of what the position of chess layer 0 is, actually. I guess it probably goes like. Chest probably goes above legs. Chest 0. No, it probably goes below legs. I'll double check. Because, yeah, I remembered the jacket. When we get to the jacket. Ugh. Yeah, the jacket. Alright. Yeah, let's do oh, look at all this chat. I will catch up on chat in just a second. What was I gonna look up? I was gonna look up oh yeah, so on the doll file, where's the chest go? Chest layer 2 or the chest layer 0 goes below hands, above legs. Okay, so I was right. Below hands, above legs. Okay, good. And then oh yeah. I'm just trying to think, like, there are other pieces of equipment that we'll have to animate. I'm pretty sure it's the mask, the jacket, and the banner. I think it might just be those three, but I don't know. I could be wrong. All right. So what was chat saying? Oh, okay. Well, all right. I guess I didn't miss too much in chat, but thank you. Thank you all. Okay. all right, so let's do what then? Let's add boots. I think that's the next step. Boots. Boots and stuff. Yeah, okay, so just for like easiness, I'm gonna put these in I'm gonna change these back to leg 0, like, and so on, and then I'm gonna also put it in caps just so that they stand out a little more on the layer list. So legs 1, legs 2, 1A, excuse me, 1A, foot, so legs 2, legs 2A. I just spent way too much time looking at the layer list, not seeing exactly what I'm looking for right away. So hopefully this will help me see what I'm looking for a little more right away. Legs 3A. Okay. And then yeah, so legs 0 and legs 2. Right. So the boots that we're drawing on. Let me. Oh, I mean, I'm pretty sure at this point that the boots are next. So I'm pretty sure. Yeah, chain boots are next. Right, so I want to go and do that. Ah, gosh, I should not have scrolled down. I should not have scrolled down. Just a reminder of all the stuff that I still have to do. Okay, I mean, I don't have to literally do all of these, but I have to do like farmer pants. I have to do like there are a few tall boots. I have to do quite a few leg armor. All right, right, but where am I? I just did black and skirt, so now I'm doing chain boots. Yeah, so let's look at the chain boots as they have been drawn. Open game data, or not game data, sorry. Equipment, legs, chain boots. Yeah, so these ones were weird. So is Thank you, Luminar. Thank you, Luminar Fossey. That is the nicest thing that anyone has ever said to me. So these are the boots. They're like the interesting thing about them is that they have like a cuff, and then they have like a steel heel. I guess. I don't know what I was necessarily thinking when I made this. I just thought it would be cool, and so I made it. Oh, speaking of smudgy pixels, not that anyone was speaking of smudgy pixels, but if they were, those are some smudgy pixels right there. maybe it's just dust that you kick up. Maybe that's why there are smudgy pixels here and there. It's just that you're kicking up dust as you go. Alright, so let's color pick. These colors, and Should I make a new layer for this? Yeah, I guess. I won't keep like a million new layers around, but I will put in like one for now. Sorry, I'm not excited about having to have all these extra layers, but whatever. It could be worse. Okay. So, let's start with a brush size 2. And just like spec in, like the boots are going to be approximately this big. And then, actually, they might not even go up quite this high. Because they're not supposed to be tall boots, they're just supposed to be, oops, what the heck? Oh, wrong tool. They're just supposed to be, like, tall-ish. Like, they come up some distance, but then they have, like, this cuff to them is, like, the interesting part about that. And then, alright, so let's get the other color here, the other darker tone, and, because we'll use this for the sole of the foot, sole of the shoe, sole of the boot, the heart of the cards, no. Actually, yeah, I might want to bring back like the oh, you know what I could do is I might bring back the file open what was it, legs, the original shoes, because the original shoes were a brown tone, and I think it, oh, sorry, this is the wrong version, this is the old version, I need the art test version, because the yeah, the thing about the like switching from the sandals back to the boots is like gonna be slightly more awkward. What am I looking for? Legs art test. Yeah, I'm looking for these because we have the foot shape or like the boot, not like the boot, but or, I mean it's like the shoe boot, whatever. Like this shape is already like drawn out, which is, I don't know, slightly advantageous, I guess. Maybe, maybe not. But whatever. So copy this. I can. I'll just keep these two around for reference. I'll close these other ones. Okay. Don't save. Actually, I only need one for reference, so I'll just keep this one around for reference. It's like the best vantage point. All right. So copy. So on this new layer, paste this. Put it at 6161. I assume is like the usual location. And really, all I want here is the boot. And so yeah, just so that I don't have to like redraw this shape, and then I guess like to get it, because it's not the right tone, it's like a slightly different brown tone, so whoops. Not like that. No, you know what, I think I'm gonna, since I nailed it earlier, I think I'm gonna try the adjustment trick again, like the one where I just like try and shift the sample to the correct tone using only my mind. No. but like yeah, so image or edit, invert selection. Let's zoom in here. Actually, let's make an educated guess so that I don't have to like rely on my uncanny abilities. All right, so this one is 21, 32, 45. This one is 22, 45, 40. Okay, so yeah, I just wanted to make sure actually that they had the right hue. And it looks like the hue is off by like minus one, so I want to add one hue to it. One hue point to it. But other than that, yeah. Okay, so adjustments, hue and saturation. So add 1 point of hue. And then, yeah, the real thing that we want to do though is like drop down the lightness a little bit, increase the saturation. All right, apparently we need to use the brightness contrast too, because yeah. Okay. How is that? Like, where, how far off is that? This one is now 22:39. This one's 21:43. 40. It's close. Whatever. Adjust brightness and contrast. Whoop, not like that. Those are the old numbers. This is let's start at 0. And then so yeah, more contrast. But I guess more brightness as well. Wait. I don't know. This one's not working out as well as I'd hoped. Yeah, I'll probably just want to redraw it. All right, never mind. Never mind. False alarm. All right, deselect. Let's just draw it over. I mostly just wanted to borrow the foot to like keep the shape, I guess. Make sure the shape of the foot was the same or consistent or whatever. So, right. Actually, no. You know what? Hold on. I should be able to like spill for the start, or like. I should be able to spill. Yeah, just for like the broad stroke sort of conversion. Yeah. What is the hotkey? F is the hotkey for spill tool. Yeah, of course. Why wouldn't spill tool be the F key? Of course, it's the F key. Of course. All right, whatever. All right, yeah, there we go. And that's just yeah. All right, that's that. So I think okay. Apart from the fact that that took like a minute to accomplish, I think like in general that won't be that'll be like a fairly straightforward, simple way to it's like to get the boots the right shape for starters. Okay, and then so yeah. So what we want to do now is probably use a slightly bigger brush to draw in the cuffs and the detail. For the detail, I will use a smaller brush. Yeah, because like it's not anything crazy. It's just wait, how's it supposed to look? Yeah, I guess yeah, these were like oddly difficult to draw the first time. So, it might take a second to figure out exactly what it was that I did the first time around to get them looking right. But, it shouldn't be that hard, I think. I mean, it's entirely doable. Oh, yeah, and then the other thing was the heel. The heel was the other weird part, because the heel, has that, like, metal piece on it. So, like, oh, it's the same color as the skirt. So it's like do do do. It's just like I don't know. It's just like a metal piece that like covers the heel. I don't even understand what it is exactly. I don't know. I thought it could look cool, kinda. I'm not displeased with how it turned out. It's kind of like weirdly L-shaped a little bit. I don't know why. All right. So oh yeah, let's Right, yeah, so the bottom isn't shaded, so or the bottom is shaded. It's in shading, so we can just do that, I guess. That should be fine. Should be totally cool. Yeah, I don't know. I kinda changed the shape on it, which I didn't mean to do. But hey, Protostra. Thank you, Protospasm. You always know just what to say. what is oh, this is the yeah, this is the this is like the adventurer's right foot, which I don't know, you'd kind of think like the toe might come up a little bit higher. Like that. I don't know. Not that it matters, but I'm gonna do that. Just cause. This is probably fine. This is fine. How it is. This is good. Totally good. All set. Good to go. So, alright, let's do the other one now, I guess. Alright, so the other foot is like this one, and then it's like select all, copy. Do do do. I'm just gonna flatten this layer, because like I said, I don't want like a million stray layers like flailing all over the place. So, let's add in a new layer though, paste this in, put it down to 6161. And deselect. Let's get rid of this pant, and then let's spill. Actually, let's get rid of the little picky edges too, because that's those, the in, that inside curve doesn't matter as much as the outside curve of the boot. So let's spill. Oops, no. Spill that color there, and then let's paint in the rest of the boot. So this is slightly awkward because this is like entirely in shading. There's no, like no light tones here, which I might want to cheat on. I might want to introduce like, I think I actually did this the last time too. Like with these boots, like the detail is so weird that like the only way I was able to render it was to like cheat shading tones into places where I typically would not actually include them. So I think, yeah, I'm just gonna have like a ring around the, if my tablet would participate, and put like a, just like a, like an edge of shading, or an edge of highlighting, on like the, around like there, I guess. Actually, no, I don't have to do it on the heel, 'cause like, yeah, whatever, I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm just gonna do like that slight bit of shading, I guess, and then, or highlighting, and then, yeah, no, this is fine. Yeah, just the metal heel again. And then that's actually, this is actually fine. I don't have to worry about that. Okay. Cool. So, save that, I guess. I can smush that down too. So now let's do legs, 0, A, and so on. Actually, I should probably take a screenshot of, the original version, just so I make sure that they look consistent. And I can close the I can close this one. I don't really have to look at that one. So print screen, file new. Okay, paste. Okay, just for reference. All right, and I'm done with these, and these. Or no, I'm done with these. Okay. So copy. Now let's go to legs layer 0A. And legs layer 2A and legs layer 0A, we will add a new layer, paste in this, put down to 61, 61, and delete the pant. Do to do. And some of these picky little whatevers. Okay. And then we will draw. Oh, yeah, so. The color pick, the boot color, the heel of the boot, or the shaded color of the boot. We can spill this. It doesn't really matter about this lower line because like this lower line gets cut off anyways. I just the only reason I keep it tidy, like actually bother to erase that lower line, is just so it doesn't like throw off how I perceive the image to be looking, I guess. All right, so. I click on like the fake tab bar of the screenshot sometimes, which is silly. I'll just hide it so I'm not tempted to do that. excuse me. okay, so do to do. Here we go. Do to do to do. All right, so let's cover that in. Oh yeah, and so this boot. Yeah, this boot is like weird. It's like at an angle, so it'll be a little weird to render. It basically comes up about this high, and so this part is like kind of squished down. Although it can fan out a little bit in the back because it's supposed to have a little bit of that to it. And then, all right, so let's draw in the shading of the cuff, and then. And I guess the heel is all that's left. So let's start with the shading tone. It won't be 100% shading, but it'll start shaded. Do to do. Again, I don't want it to go below this line, which is supposed to be the cutoff. And then what? And then oh yeah, slightly highlighted, just ever so slightly. 'Cause like. I don't know, this metal isn't shiny. Like a lot of times when I work with metal, like I give it like a specific sheen. This metal doesn't have like a specific sheen. It's supposed to be more like burnished, or not burnished, like a more matte finished, I guess. But it should at least have a little bit of lighting to it, I guess. Okay. So we're done with this one now. Let's go to this one and copy. Oh yeah, I can squish those layers together now. Layer 8 onto legs layer 0A. And so now legs layer 2A. So add a layer above it, paste, and slide this down to 6161. As such, and let's lasso the green pants situation that we got going on here, and then right, so the boot color, this one's like almost entirely lightened. No, that's the darker tone. That's got to be the darker tone. It looks light here, but I think it's actually supposed to be the darker tone. So let's pick the darker color and spill that. Spill, please. No, don't slide this. No, don't. I'm hitting the freaking F button. Be the F tool. F tool. Okay. There we go. So now, yeah, like before, so the, yeah, this one, like, you can barely make out, like, any of the detail on this, but, like, again, I'm going to cheat the highlighting just to, like, convey, like, a little bit of what's kind of supposed to be going on there, and then I will, just, like, put a, you're not, like, yeah, you really can't really make out exactly what's going on here, but technically it is vaguely accurate as to, like, what this boot is actually supposed to be shaped like, so there you go. okay, so, you know, when I screenshot, like, the game, I should probably make sure that, like, all the characters are, like, either in this frame of animation, like, the, you know, leg out frame of animation, or in, like, the leg back frame, like, the other, like, because the crouchy, like, if I take a screenshot and catch the character like this, like, that, this character is clearly crouching, like, yeah. I might wanna cheat that. or something. Cause yeah. Alright, anyways. The heel on this is a little bit, the heel on the this one up here is a little bit big. It's a little too much heel. So I'll just like dial that back slightly. Okay. Whatever, I'm gonna stop. No. Alright. One last thing. When I spilled, it like it ate a little bit too much of the toe, so I'm gonna just steal some of it back. Okay, and that's fine. Okay, so save this, and then what? And then right. So the next layer. So squish layer 18 and legs 2A, and now let's go on to 3 and 1. Let's select all, copy, new layer above legs 1, paste 6161, and let's get rid of the green legs as per usual, lasso tool, why am I so zoomed out, and then as per usual, let's spill. Here and spill here. Wait, what? Why is that the same color? I must have picked the wrong color. Spill Oh, yeah, right, because it does that stupid thing where if you color pick while after spilling, it like changes the color that you spilled, because it's a jerk. okay. So yeah, there we go. And then so brushwork now. Let's draw in the pant leg or the boot cuff over the pant leg. Oops, I think I went a little too high with that. And let's compare just to make sure. Yeah, because I think the boots are actually a little bit lower than they were last time. Like, I think I might have shortened them a little bit in this version, which is fine as long as I'm consistent about it. I'm getting way too sharp edges here, so I'm going to switch to a slightly bigger brush so I don't accidentally make it look completely dumb. Okay, and then I'll switch back to a smaller brush to put in, like, the detail, which is, like, as such. So I guess here there's like a fair amount of shading on this leg because it's like supposed to be slightly in the background. Or like it's like not the leg face, it's not the leg on the side facing the camera, it's the leg on the side facing away from the camera. So do do. All right, that's probably fine. And then the heel. Is that, yeah, it looks like it could be the same boot. Okay. The heel. And the heel will be basically the same. Do do do. Be nice if my tablet didn't just like. Sometimes I'll like start to draw and it'll just like stop. It'll just like. The cursor will like maybe move like a pixel and then it'll just stop. And it's like. It'd be really nice is if instead of just like stopping for no particular reason, it didn't and continued to move and I could use it like it was supposed to work. That'd just be really cool. It's one of those features that I think maybe they should have considered adding to this product. okay. so let's right, let's color pick the lighter tone and just put in like a dab of it. I mean, actually, there'd be even less of it here, so it'd just be like, I don't know, the very slightest amount. Like that, I guess is fine. That doesn't really capture the right shape. It's supposed to be a little more angular. It was looking a little too rounded, or like diagonal. It's supposed to be a little more like, well, that's not right. Oh yeah, why am I going to that other image to color pick when I can just color pick from the chainmail that's right here? Oh, maybe it's the heel actually. Maybe this part of the heel is not looking angular enough. That's a little bit better, I guess. I'll leave that for now. Actually, just put like a little darker tone. It was making the like the way the gray and the brown blended together was making it look like weird, but okay, this is fine. Okay. So, let's okay, squish these layers together and head over to legs layer 3 and let's do what then? Let's oh yeah, no, that's not how I usually start. Right, because I'm a cheater and I cheat and I use this instead. On my new layer, I paste this side down to 6161. And the reason I'm cheating is just to keep consistency in like the shoe shape, because it's like I mean I say this fairly often, but like the whole point is that like these are just like different armor sets for the same adventure. Like it's not supposed to literally be like the adventurer's feet are like changing shape over the course of the journey, so maybe getting like slightly more calloused, but other than that, it's supposed to be roughly the same. So, yeah, you know what's funny is like the reason I ha like I the whole the, like if you've heard like if prior to this week you'd heard me talk about the animation system in this game, the reason I would have told you that the game previously had ran at the frame rate that it did is that. The animation work would to like get it to run faster than that would be so time consuming. And I think part of the reason I've gone this far with like the animation upgrade is that I think I actually like forgot for a little while. Like I've been saying it for so long that I kind of forgot like exactly how much animation work would be involved exactly. But here I am doing animation work and I don't know. I can't, like, I complain a lot more than I should because really, like, we're making fine progress. I think, like, the, yeah, I don't know. I don't know how to describe it except that, like, animation has never really gripped me. Like, the thing when I draw, like, the thing I like about drawing is, like, drawing something new. And, like, animation is, like, the exact opposite of that. Animation is drawing the same thing a million times. So like I was saying yesterday, I have like an immense amount of respect for people who can do this, like for real. Because like I find it harrowing to do like even a little bit, even like the slight amount, I find like Well, you've heard me complain. I've been complaining, the whole time I've been working on this has just been like an unending series of complaints. Complaints, stupid puns, random weird face noises, and at least we're making progress, right? At least we're making progress. okay. I think this heel should just be lighter overall. Because I was putting a tone of shade onto it, but I don't think that was right. Or I wasn't reading right, so this is fine. Okay. So now I can squish these layers together. And one more set of boots. One more set of boots are in order. And then we will be done with these chain boots. So what could happen? Sorry, I'm just gonna. My back is slightly sore, so I'm going to just take this as an opportunity to bend over at a weird angle, or I don't know, just stretch my back. Sorry. And also just look at what's next. So chain boots, and then I guess I could have kept the boots on a separate layer, because I think the next thing that happens is that we actually change the pants before we change the boots, if I recall correctly. I might be wrong on that, but I think we. So let's see what happens. So chain boots, chain chest is not legs, black sleeves, buckler, mask, fox cloth, headdress, linen sleeves, buckler, linen shirt, linen pants, chain. Oh. I think this means linen pants, chain boots, I think is what this means. And then linen pants. So those are the next two updates. Yeah, I think the first one is linen pants, chain boots. I forget if that means the skirt is there or the skirt leaves first. Let's find out real quick. So legs, linen pants, chain comes first. Oh no, okay, the boots do go away. But the skirt stays. Interesting. Interesting. All right, well, sure. And then the next one, linen pants, no chain, is just the pants without the chain. Interesting. Oh, but there's a belt. I mean, minor point, but yeah. Okay, so I guess the next thing I want to do is after I'm done with these boots is I want to basically take the pants off the skirt. I want to cut these black pants off the skirt and put the other pa oh, excuse me. Sorry. I guess okay, so we get chain boots here, and then there are a bunch of levels. There's chain chest, there's black sleeves, there's buckler, there's mask, there's fox, there's cloth headdress. There's linen shirt. Okay, so yeah, there are a lot of levels before you get to linen pants chain. It's just it's funny 'cause the usually it's like first out first or first in first out, so if the skirt appeared before the boots, usually the skirt would disappear before the boots, but it's not always that case, so oh. Sorry, I missed chat. The face noises. Oh, I had one that I kept doing whenever I copy and pasted. I don't even remember what it was, but I remember thinking to myself, that's new. Where'd that one come from? But bloop bloop beep bop, bleep bling blong. it's basically really bad scatting, I think. I'm like a person who should never be involved in jazz vocals. trying to do scatting is basically what it turns out to be a lot of the time. Okay, so we can finish up these boots. And yeah, the next now, I was gonna say the next few won't be as difficult, but I shouldn't even jinx it, because as soon as I say that, it's gonna turn out to be excruciatingly painful. So, I'll just keep on, keep on keeping on. Okay, so paste here, and then Hoi. Oh wow, sorry. I don't. Oh man, I knew that this was gonna be a new and different sort of thing. I did not realize how little fortitude I'd have for this. I'm embarrassed about how bad an animator I am, apparently. I never knew. I knew I wouldn't I don't know. I thought it would just be like difficult. I didn't think it would be like literally that I am like a bad at it. I'm like that, yeah, I don't know. That I'd be like incapable at it. Or like just like I don't know. I don't even know what to say. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. This is like almost as bad as the times that I've like tried to stream games. One time I on a whim, I was like, I'm gonna stream games instead of game dev today, and that was horrible. And then another time someone like requested it, like someone was just like insistent that I try streaming games instead of game dev. And I already knew at that point how bad it was gonna go because I'd tried it once before. But it went even worse somehow. No. Oh no, that one was really bad. And so apparently animating is kind of like that, I guess. Like the only times I've really felt so strongly compelled to apologize on stream are that one time that I swore loudly on stream and when I work on animating or when I play games. Those are the things that are not apparently my strengths. If you had a big long list of everything that I could do, everything that I could do well. Oh man. I bet it's adorable when you wiggle your nose. I bet people are thinking, "Aw, how cute." I bet that's what people are thinking. wait. Shoot, no, you know what I should have said instead just then was one of those like Leslie Knope things, I don't even know. So if I could think faster on my feet, I'd be able to come up with like one of those like Leslie Knope type compliments of what is something that actually wiggles its nose? I was trying to think of like what adorable animal like wiggle would be the most adorable to have wiggled its nose, but all right. Well, oh, shoes. You said shoes. For some reason, I read that as nose. okay. let's continue. yep. Maybe. Oh, so maybe if next time you feel the urge to wiggle your shoes, wiggle your shoes, you could wiggle your nose instead. I bet that would go over much better. I bet. no, don't listen to me. Which is yeah. All right, here we are. Here we are, drawing boot stuff. Phase 7 of Project Boots get drawn. Everything's going according to plan. We've almost completed our mission. We just have all right, on to phase 8. I'm gonna call this done. Yeah, that's done. Phase 8 of Boot Quest. yeah, so once again, 6161 is the position here, and what is happening? So let's do 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 do. Ah, it's tablet. Why have you abandoned me? Tablet, you terrible, you cruel, cruel tablet. Like the cursor was just frozen right there, but I was like continuing to drag my pen across the tablet in vain, hoping that it would register the input. Someday. I'm pretty sure it's I'm pretty sure it has something to do with this button on the side of the tablet. Because I think sometimes that when it happens, like it's me, because it's me that I accidentally like, nudge this button with my finger or something. Incidentally, this button does like, as far as I can tell, nothing. Oh, cool! I got it out. Because I've been trying to like get rid of it. Now it just has like exposed electronics, which is I'm sure fantastic. I'm sure this is gonna like make this product last forever, having exposed electronics. But I think that's like part of what was happening. So, all right, now it's like really uncomfortable because like there's these like just like blunt edges, or like not even blunt, but like just like slightly pointy edges having going on here. But hey, at least we got rid of that stupid button. So that's good. We're making progress of sorts. Okay. So let's the stylus actually feels slightly lighter now. Like this button doesn't like weigh much, but like it's funny. It just feels like I don't know. It's such a like it's like a pencil is like such a light implement that like you use such fine control over that like just losing something as simple as that little button piece. It feels like significantly lighter now. Ooh, wow, no, it has it. Oh wow. And because like the weight was lost from like the near the tip, just like the motion of like going like this, it feels like really fast now. It feels like there's no like resistance to it. Maybe is there like a little weighted piece in here? Like it literally, I don't know. I again, it's not it's probably just 'cause like it's such a fine like the whole stylus itself is very lightweight. So like it's not that that button weighed a lot, it's that like nothing on the stylus weighs very much, so the fact that it lost like basically any weight is like noticeable. But yeah, I was not expecting that necessarily. I wasn't really thinking about that far. It feels more. I like. I know the stylus didn't lose any like structural integrity there. excuse me. I know it didn't like lose any integrity because of that button, like the button wasn't like a load-bearing button or anything, but like it feels like fragile now, just because it's like so much. It feels like such a lighter weight that it like, I'm like when I press it to the when I press it to this the thing, like nothing is different actually, but I feel like I'm gonna like break it if I if I press it too hard. I mean, I guess maybe it's always been a little bit fragile, and now I'm just like now because it feels more lightweight, I'm like more even more cognizant of that, but. Yeah, I don't know. The things you learn by biting and ripping with your teeth a button off of a stylus. things you learn. Okay, we're almost done. We're wrapping up on phase eight of project boot have. I'm not good at naming projects. all right. Boot have complete, I think. Basically complete. Boot having is go. Yeah, okay, I'll stop touching it now. All right, so save this. And so now we can take extents and we can export. Oh, contact. I can't think of anything witty. Contacts. I can't think of anything witty. okay, so let's I Earlier I was talking about how like I still don't know how to manage I still don't know how to, oh yeah, wait, hold on, I was about to take extents, but I should show all oh I should switch these layers together. And I should show all the layers so I can take proper extents. Okay. Yeah, I was talking earlier about how oops, I don't need to show I don't need to show back layer 0. Oh, I can get rid of back layer 0. Back layer 0? Yeah, back layer 0 I can get rid of. No, wait, the mask is part of the back. So do I need to keep it around? No, I can do that later. And I can get rid of chest layer 02. Wait, what did I just do? Oh, wait, I added a new layer. I didn't delete the layer. I can get rid of chest layer 0 because like I do need to do the jacket thing at some point, but I don't have to do it right now. I can like come back for it at the end. Yeah, because like there's some of the jacket art I think actually goes on the leg layer, which is slightly whatever, but I'll just do the legs first, and then I'll come back for the jacket stuff later. I think. I might be remembering it wrong. It might all be on the jacket. But no, I don't know. We'll see. Okay. Oh, excuse me. Sorry. Okay. Now, yeah, extents and exports. All right, I remember how this goes. Do-do-do. Oops. 1 pixel too high, 1 pixel too short on this edge. So first, let's get rid of a pixel on top, and then add a pixel over here. All right, good. So 6161 is what I like to see. For no particular reason, I just it amuses me or pleases me when the legs line up at pixel 6161. Okay, so what am I doing? Oh yeah, data. So excuse me. So 6161, 50, 20, 50, 22. Oh, wait a second. That's too many pixels down. I accidentally added an extra pixel down here with this boot, but it's not actually supposed to be there. So it's just like not there. Okay. So yeah, okay, so 50, 21. Okay. So yeah, so 61, 61, 50, f sorry, 50, not, and then save as, what is this? Chain boots. Equipment, legs, chain boots, so chain boots art test, chain boots art test, and save this as data.txt. Okay, and then excuse me. Sorry. And then what? Like, sorry. And then right, so the exporting process. I might need a new brain. Like, maybe I just literally need a new brain. Maybe I just like, maybe my current one is just like worn out, and like I just need a. I haven't had a tune up in a while. Like, this is just like, this has just been like the default like brain that I started with, and I've just kind of like let it keep on doing its thing. No, I don't know. Like yesterday, I thought it was because that I took Friday off last week that I was like, I don't know, just feeling like slightly out of it. But like, I don't know. Maybe I'm just like legit, just not having a yeah run defrag on my brain. I'm just not having a very good brain week, I guess. But I can make it through. No, you know what? I mean, like, I really believe that a fair amount of this is because, like, I'm usually, like, the nature of my work is usually very different. Like, the nature of my work is usually, like, I'm usually, like, solving problems, and, like, I'm usually, like, even when I'm working on, like, art stuff, I'm, like I said before, I'm working on, like, new art. I'm not working on, like, the same art piece again and again and again and again and again. So, I think I'm just not used to that. Like I said, I'm a child. The smallest little change in like what I'm working on will like throw me off completely, apparently. yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Protospasm. No, that's a much more that's a much nicer way to say it. You're very generous. Oh yeah, so the reason I'm bouncing up and down, Zanklord, is because I am climbing stairs right now. Not like a staircase or anything, but just like I'm like standing on a small stair climbing thing, and it helps me think. If I have to work on stuff like this, I can at least exercise Thank you, Brothers. That one is especially poetic, I feel. Okay. So, all right, 2A is this one, and then two more to go. Oops, sorry, keep like bumping stuff, and I'm just I don't know. I don't even know what I am. All right, save this, and then legs 3A. All right, one more to go. Okay, paste, save, and oops. Oh, oops! I forgot to name. Which one did I fail to name correctly? I failed to name three correctly. And then this one is supposed to be 3A. Okay. Okay. All right. Sorry. I'm going to be briefly boring, real quick. I just have to look something up. Super fast, and then I'll get back to. All right. So yeah. So then the next thing that we want to do is we want to do like the chain thing. We want to keep the chain skirt, but we want to do the the yellow legs like almost in full. The only thing, the only piece of the new legs that we want to put in that we're not putting in now is like the upper part that the like the area that the area that the skirt covers. So like the top of the pants, there's nothing special there except for the belt. The belt is JR Dimple, sorry for mispronouncing your name, but hey, how's it going? Welcome. Yeah, so we'll do everything except the belt at first, and then we'll do the belt separately. Yeah, that should be fine. Oh, you know, once I finish this animation, and I'll there, I might want to do like one other pass later, because like when the when it, this is all in context, like when the art when the like when these pieces are all together, I've been like drawing them on the setting of this shirt, but like sometimes like there's padded armor and sometimes there's like other stuff that like looks a little different than the shirt, so like some of the stuff like once it's put together like might it might not fit perfectly right, so I might have to come back and I might have to come back and tweak some of this stuff, but that'll be like down the line because I'm not gonna put like every little piece together just to make sure that it checks out. And like if there is like some of those like mismatches, like it'll be very subtle too. So I really don't. It's not anything like urgent that I have to worry about. Sorry. Yeah, let's do this. Let's do this thing. Oh yeah, so first thing, as per usual, I'm going to check that that worked out okay. So what was that? That was so black and skirt our test. So this is so let's replace this with chain boots. Chain boots art test. And oops, replace all and then save this and then let's look at our art test file and see how this looks. Do you have the outfit pieces at different depths? Because then just let the top be higher than the pants, I'd say. Yeah, I do it the other way because the way it's layered, well, so for one thing, the torsos actually resolve even worse than the legs. Like the torsos, because I've been doing it this way the whole time, like torsos, like if you actually ever saw the bottom of them, they just like it's not like there's not like a hem on the shirt or anything. It just kind of like melts down into like nothing. And yeah, oh, and then the other thing is belts. If I like the pants affect the waistline more often than the shirt does. So if I wanted to like let's say like I was like oh, so actually yeah with the skirt and with the belts that we're about to add, the skirt comes up like let's say to this high, and then so to make the belt come up higher than that, even though what I'd really want to be changing is the pants, like the I mean, I could just put that on the shirt layer, I guess. But the belt shifts a little bit as like the player walks, because like like your waistline, like if you lift like one of your, you can't really see it because it's off screen, but like if you lift up your knee, I don't know why I'm actually doing it because you can't see it. Like if I lift up my knee, then like the belt on my pants, like it shifts upwards, right? Because like my leg, oh yeah, yeah. But oh yeah, I'm supposed to be seeing how this animation looks, and it looks fine, I think. I think it looks fine. I mean, it's a little hard to tell in the snow, so I'll check it out. Sorry for putting my face so close to the camera. I'll try it like in the go to mountains. So that's y'all. And yeah, that seems fine. I guess I should be thankful for that. Like, I've been checking all of these to make sure that they look fine, and they have. They've literally all looked fine. So, that's good. That's good, at least. Oh, yeah, look, we have this nice little comparison, like, how it looks now and how it could look. So, I mean, please ignore all the pink, because. Oh, wait, no, you know what I can do? I can. Instead of just telling people to ignore the pink, I can just make the pink go away. I can just set my monitor to use the in OBS. I can just set my monitor to use a chroma key, and I can just yeah, there we go. Right, so it's now instead of the pink, you see just the blackness, which is I don't know, it's less distracting I think to have it like solid black than to have it like bright pink. Okay, so good then, and yeah, let's continue, onwards. Ever onwards, onwards and onwards, onwards forever. Ah, so let's look at the yeah, let's okay, so we'll want to preserve the skirt, which I guess like we'll want to preserve the skirt. I'm trying to think strategy here. What do these shoes look like with the what do the shoes that you get with the with the linen pants, what do they look like? Are they just like, I think they're akin to the gray boots that you had earlier in the game. Oh, which is funny because those gray boots lasted forever. I think they are like akin to the gray boot. They're probably like a slightly darker tone than the gray boot. But we can use the gray boot as the foundation. So yeah, so I'm gonna make a ton of extra layers again. Okay, so let's hide a bunch of these legs. I mean, the legs in the back I can just get rid of completely. Yeah, the legs in the back I can just get rid of completely. Yeah. The legs in the back I can just get rid of. Sorry, I'll stop saying that. Right, so I'll just like nuke these layers instead of hiding them. Because right, the only reason I'm keeping the layers in the front at all is for the purpose of the skirt. Right, so file, open, legs. So what's a good one to steal the, I guess I could do the red pants. The red pants. Or even just like the boots, like even just the original boots would be fine. Yeah. Let's just go with these. Sorry, so the reason I'm taking these original boots is because right, so like these boots are kind of akin to these boots. Again, like these ones are slightly darker tone, so I want to shift them slightly, but for the most part these are gonna serve pretty close. And like the these like yellow pants are like similar enough to these like if I just take these blue pants and color shift them, then in order to convert them, like that's like most of the conversion, and then the rest of it is just to make them like these pants are a little baggy around the ankles, so I'll just want to do that, and then and yeah, so this should be fairly straightforward. Are these in the correct order? 0, 0A, 1, 1A. They look mostly in the correct order. So actually I'm gonna close most of these reference images for now. I'll just leave this one open as a reminder. Okay. So yeah, so let's copy this. Make a new layer. I'm gonna make a new layer underneath legs layer 0. So I'm gonna put it down here. I'm gonna paste this in. This goes at 6161, of course, because doesn't it always? And then, yeah, so I'll get rid of, there's a little bit peeking up out of the top here. So we can get rid of that. And then, right, so on this legs 0 layer, we can get rid of most of all of this. And, yeah, so that's like the gist.